Hello, I'm Scott Card and welcome to my channel. If this is the first time here, I hope you find the content helpful. If you're a returning viewer, I appreciate your continued support. Today, I have a short video for you regarding the RC time constant and how it is applied to a charging circuit. We'll look at the circuit and simulate it before we dive into the formula. We'll learn how to apply the formula and predict the capacitor voltage at any point during the charging cycle. We will then look at how to graph the curve in Excel. Okay, here we can see the simple circuit, which has a resistor and a capacitor in series. 12 volt signal is applied to the resistor and the capacitor is connected to the ground to complete the circuit. Once we start the simulation, you will note that the voltage at the capacitor starts to rise quickly and the current is high to start. The high current is the result of a large voltage potential or voltage difference across the 100 ohm resistor. As the capacitor is filled with electrons, the capacitor voltage rises and thus the voltage across the resistor is reduced. The lower voltage potential results in a lower current and therefore the charging becomes slower. The charge curve is intuitive when we look at the graph from the simulation. Note that as the voltage increases, the current decreases. As such, we can never reach the full voltage of the supply, but we consider 99.3% close enough. If we watch the simulation long enough, we see that it has reached 12 volts, but that there is still current flowing, suggesting there is still a slight voltage potential. So how do we calculate the voltage of the capacitor at a given time during the charge cycle? We use the RC charging formula. This requires us to know the following information. R, the resistance in ohms, C, the capacitance in farads, tau, the RC time constant, that 5 tau yields 99.3% of the input voltage, the Euler number, which is 2.7182, the source voltage, and the elapsed time. We can then use this formula to calculate the voltage of the capacitor VC at that instant in time. Let's do an example problem to illustrate how this formula works and to prove that 5 tau will result in a capacitor voltage equal to 99.3% of the source voltage. We will use the following values. R equals 100 ohms, C is equal to 220 microfarads, and Vin is equal to 12.0 volts. We can calculate tau by multiplying the resistance by the capacitance, so 100 times 0.00022, which results in 0.022. This is the RC time constant for this circuit. At 5 tau, we will require 110 milliseconds to reach 99.3% of the input voltage. We can now calculate the full equation to prove this point. Note that the exponent reduces to negative 5, meaning it will be considered a full charge. But by using this formula, we can choose any time during the charge cycle to calculate the capacitor. As predicted, we see 99.3% of 12 volts is 11.9 volts at the capacitor. Here we have an Excel spreadsheet which contains the same formula. There are fields for the supply voltage, resistance, and capacitance. For each unit of tau, 22 milliseconds, there will be 10 time steps to create a smooth graph. Once the capacitor voltage is calculated, the potential across the resistor can be calculated using Ohm's law, I equals V over R, to determine the instantaneous current. These two values are then charted so that we can see that indeed the current drops as the capacitor voltage increases. At 5 tau, 110 milliseconds, we calculate 11.919 volts as predicted by the simulation. If you'd like a copy of this spreadsheet, I'll pin a link in the comments below. Hopefully you found this video helpful and entertaining. If you did, please like and subscribe. I'd love to hear from you in the comments. If you would like to know when I post new videos, be sure to hit the notify button. Thanks, and as always, have a great day. All right, bye now.